Hey, it's Ed Saleks. The show is Island Hop. We love bringing it to you. I always promise you a great show. Today I'm promising you a better than great show. I want you to listen for the first song that you're going to hear. So long as you may be right, you'll be hearing it from the Remnants.
Friday night I crashed your party. Saturday I said I'm sorry. Sunday came, you trashed me out again.
I don't even
It is the evening of the day. I sit and watch the children play, smiling faces I can see, but not for me. I sit and watch as tears go by. Thank you.
The Remnants, you guys are great. Really put on a good show. I'm enjoying the hell out of it. And I can't wait till we get to the second half of the show so we can see what else you got cooking. But you got a good sound. You really got a good sound. Starting with you, John, introduce yourself to the audience.
My name is John Farone, and I'm basically a Staten Island native. And I started the Remnants about 12 years ago. And through the years, the cast has changed, obviously, but right now I feel like we have the best Remnants band right now. I'm surrounded with great people.
I agree with you. Joe, introduce yourself to the audience.
My name is Joe Sirico. I'm the bass player of the group. I've been with the group now about maybe 5 years. And that's about it, really.
John, your turn.
Yes, John Conti, rhythm guitar, vocals. I've been with the Remnants since 2010.
Guy Conti, I've been with the band about 6 years now.
Are you related?
Yeah, my uncle.
Pat Carfora, native Staten Islander. I've been with the band about 2 years now.
Right. And
Cookie Sirico, and I've been with the band for, 4 or 5 years now?
Yeah. And you joined the band just to watch your husband play bass?
Well, to keep an eye on him, yes.
John, you started the group 12 years ago?
About 12 years ago.
Yeah. Now, I was going to ask you, the Remnants. You came up with the name, obviously.
Yeah, because when I started out, I sort of plucked different people from different bands. Either they left the bands or the bands got rid of them, so to say. And we were sort of like Remnants. So I said, you know what? That's a good name, the Remnants. And it stuck.
Yeah. Now, if somebody wants to get in touch with the Remnants, how do they do that?
Well, they can either call me at 718-858-3117 or 347-459-4600.
Check Facebook.
And you can look on Facebook. And you can also call John Farone at 718-564-5168.
Very good. We're going to get to you in a second. We got Joe. Joe.
Yes.
Tell us a little bit about when did you start playing bass?
When I started playing bass. Let's see, the earth cooled, dinosaurs roamed. I started late in life, really. I started when I was about 17 years old.
Well, that's not late in life. That's about the right time.
Well, at that time, everybody was starting to get bands together because of the Beatles came in and, you know,
right. Everybody
wanted to meet chicks. So the best way to meet chicks was pick up a guitar and go, you know.
Well, the Beatles came in after me. I was ahead of them. John, let's talk about you.
Yes.
Now, you've been with me, let's see.
Since 1991.
Moments Notice.
Right. Then we had Triple Play.
Triple Play.
Then we had Midnight Hour.
Right.
And now with the Remnants.
And Remnants, yeah.
They, you know, they keep throwing me out of bands. I got to keep joining new ones.
Let me tell you something. I know John the better part of 20 years, I guess.
Yeah.
All right? And every band that he's been with has been top shelf. Been top shelf. Moments Notice. I mean, we must have done a dozen shows with you or better.
We did about 11, 12 shows. That's how it started with us, on the Ed Saleks show.
And the one that I'll always remember the most was Triple Play. Because the band, I think, was together for one gig only. They played the Vietnam Vets, which I'm very involved with, we had our annual dinner dance, and I never saw a place light up as it did that day, and they got around to playing the Animal Song. We got to get out of this place.
Mm-hmm.
And the place just went wild. It was something that always stuck in my mind. It was really...
It's like their national anthem.
Yeah.
This is what I was told.
So. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. We enjoy doing it.
Let me ask you, let's go between the three of you here.
Sure.
Where have you been? Where are you going? What locations can people see you at?
Well, on the 7th, which is this Friday night, we're going to be right here in Staten Island at Castleton Corners.
Okay.
January 12th, we're going to be back in Brooklyn at Legends Bar and Grill on Flatbush Avenue.
Right.
I believe on the 11th, we're going to be at Trackside, right here.
Trackside over on the Railroad Avenue, yeah.
And then on January, I believe, I'm not sure, it's either the 17th or the 18th, we're going to be back at Castleton Corners.
Wow.
And then the 18th.
On Victory Boulevard.
Yeah.
And then we're starting to work on February and March, and, you know, hopefully we'll get busy.
Thank God you're busy. You're busy. You're one of those groups that's always out there.
But, you know, it's because of you, Ed, really, that, you know, you keep this, you know, open to us by making these shows
available. You got it backwards, because what's happening here is you are keeping the sound alive, okay? And we talk about that. There's only a handful of clubs left that people our age can go. My age, I don't want to date you guys. I'm older than
all of you. We're all around the same.
But, you know, it used to be, and I can remember when I was in my early 40s, there were 20 clubs on Staten Island you could go to on any given night.
That's right.
And there would be a group playing, a band, a trio, a doo-wop group, even an a cappella group you'd see from place to place. And that's diminished. But you're keeping it alive.
We try. We try to do songs that everybody knows, stuff that they can remember. You know, we basically used to pull our playlist from CBS FM. So that's the age group we were looking at.
So waiting for a few dates. We play at Empire City Casino every year.
Yeah.
And we're waiting to get on the 2019 schedule. So we do play 3-4 dates there every year.
Oh, no, so I could go up there and lose my money while you play.
Yeah, more or less. Yeah, yeah. Sure.
That's usually what happens when I go to casinos. Yeah. Hey, Guy, tell us about you. How long are you with the group?
I've been with the group about 6 years now.
About 6 years now? Yeah. Hey, and what is your background in music?
Well, my father played the guitar a bit, and Johnny, you know, got me into the Beatles at a very, very early age. I mean, I remember 4 years old, him making me listen to Help. And
he punished you.
I wouldn't say that, you know, but, you know, between that and him playing, you know, I got into it. I got interested.
You know, if you ever find a real doo-wop lover, though, he'll tell you he hates the Beatles.
Oh, I know.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I know. They think the Beatles killed him.
Absolutely. Not the Beatles, per se, the British invasion.
Right.
And it was all over haircuts.
Yes.
Next.
Okay.
You are?
Pat Carfora.
I know that already.
Okay.
Tell us about your background in music.
I've been playing for about 40 years. I play with a lot of doo-wop groups and disco bands. You know.
There's something you don't hear very much of
bands
lately.
On Staten
disco
Island.
Bands.
You know, Witness, Brooklyn Keys, the Remnants.
Oh, that's right. You were a Witness. We were talking about that earlier, yeah. And you're going to get Witness to come on the show.
Yeah.
Right, please.
Them and the Brooklyn Keys.
Yes. Well, Brooklyn Keys, I'm waiting for Elmo. He's, you know, Elmo is a very dear friend, so.
He's a great guy.
Yeah. What is your background in music other than?
I've just been playing since I was like 18 years old.
Who would be your favorite artist?
Mostly the oldies singers, you know, Dion. Stuff like that.
Good choice. Very good.
Yeah.
And we saved the best for last. Cookie Sirico.
Oh.
Your husband's over there, so.
Yeah, he is.
Yeah, I know. He's watching, too. Cookie, tell us about your background in music. I know it all, but we want the audience to know.
Oh, boy. Well, I spent 30 years with Reparata and the Delrons. I started with them in 1969, and we continued to 2000 when we retired.
Yeah, you did the show at the beach for us.
Yeah, did the beach. Yep.
That was a show and a half.
That was excellent.
I mean, that was before the borough president started doing beach shows. We did the show down there, and they were expecting 1,000 people.
Oh.
And we ended up with 15,000 people.
Yeah, easy.
They had a close Capodanno Boulevard.
Yep.
It was quite an experience.
It was amazing.
All right, other than Reparata, what is your favorite, your background in music?
Oh, boy. Wow. I love the Supremes.
Of course, she'd pick a girl group. Would you expect her to say the Drifters?
Actually, yes. My very beginning was singing with guys in my old neighborhood in Brooklyn. We used to sing in apartment house hallways to get that echo, that, you know, certain sound that you needed. That's how I actually started. And then I met Joe, and then through Joe, I met Mary, and then that's how the ball started rolling.
Oh, yes. Well, you're doing a great job. You're doing a great job. I'm having a ball watching the group. And I got to tell you what, But the audience, if you're out there and you see the Remnants are playing someplace, stop in and say hello. Okay? You don't even have to tell them you saw them on the show. Just tell them you're doing a great job, because they really are. Now, I got to ask you a favor. We got to finish the second half of the show. So we're going to have to break our little coffee cluster up here. And everybody get pick up your guitar, your bass guitar, Mr. Bassman. And
he's going to haunt me about this all.
Yeah. And give us the second half of the show.
You got it. Absolutely.
Don't change the channel. They're coming right back at you. I promise you.
sky.
Your mama don't dance and your daddy don't rock and roll. When evening rolls around and it's time to go to town, where do you go? To rock and roll. The old folks say that you gotta entertain by ten. If you're out on a date and you bring it home late, it's some sense. And it's all because your mama don't dance and your daddy don't rock and roll. Your mama don't dance and your daddy don't rock and roll. When evening rolls around and it's time to go to town, where you go? To rock and roll.
Oh, I got you, babe.
Promised you a great show, a better than great show, and they even went past that. Remnants, you guys are great. You're really great. John, thank you. Thank you. Joe, Cookie, everybody else in the group. I can't thank you enough for being here. Thank you so much, guys. You keep watching Island Hop. We love you for watching. 30 years going strong, and we're going to be coming back at you with the 31st year in February.